Welcome back. This section is our community resource partner, and tonight it's the Moveable Feast, and my next guest is Mr. Terry Mullins, who is the executive director. Correct. Welcome.
Thank you.
Now, I've heard of God's Pantry and Meals on Wheels, the food, but honestly, until we had you guys on, this is the first time I've heard of Moveable Feast, so tell me about it.
Well, oddly enough, last month was our 20 years in operation here in Lexington. We prepare and then deliver a meal to the home of people here in Fayette County with HIV/AIDS or on hospice care for any reason. We also deliver to the caregiver and any dependent children in the home.
And you actually make the meals, package them, and get them out there?
Yes.
How many do you do?
Today we send out right about 150 meals.
And when I looked at your website, you've done like a 500,000 total?
Yes, we've done over 560,000 meals in those 20 years of operation.
Okay, now, you know, you think of food as, okay, somebody is in hospice care, they have HIV and they need medicines and medical care, but really nutrition is important.
Nutrition is medicine in a lot of cases, especially with the HIV meds that people have to take. They're very harsh on the system. The food will help ease that, ease the nausea that comes with the harsh medications. And plus, we focus on low income, of course. And that also, we give them good nutrition that they otherwise couldn't afford and maybe even not be able to prepare themselves if they had the food.
And you can stretch the dollar. I also saw that it's, you know, a couple bucks and you can make a meal.
Yes, our meal costs are running right about just a hair over, like it's $2.05 per meal. That's food and packaging to the home.
And you think about having somebody admitted to the hospital, and a hospital bill is horrendous, you know. And sometimes if you just feed those people, you can avoid that.
You can avoid the hospital stay a lot of times. There's been studies done that say good nutrition to HIV patients can save the community $45,000 a year per patient.
And that's a lot compared to a $2 meal.
Yeah.
Now, how do you do that for $2?
Oh, we get some donations, and God's Pantry helps us. And plus, we most of our food comes through like a regular restaurant supplier, but of course we buy in bulk so that we can bring that cost down.
Okay, so if somebody wants to get involved, getting help, do you need volunteers? Do you need money? Tell us how other folks can help if they want to.
Always need volunteers. We need volunteer delivery drivers to deliver that food to the home. We're always short on drivers. But yeah, money also helps.
Always. How many do you have a lot of volunteers now? Do you have regular staff? How do you manage?
Well, put out that 150 meals a day. Right now we have three paid staff, myself and two people in the kitchen.
So you could use some people to help get that done.
Yeah.
Okay. And how we look on the screen there, can they contact you? The phone number, the website, is that the best way if they would like to help?
Either way, the phone number or there's a place on the website to just send me an email.
Okay. So we know how the volunteers can get there to help. What if I'm somebody with HIV or a hospice patient and I need meals? How do I access your system?
Well, generally, most of our clients are recommended through the care coordinators. If you have HIV and you're low income, you'll be assigned a care coordinator or a social worker that will assess your needs and so forth and get in contact with us. Or hospice or Bluegrass Care Navigators will contact us for people low income that need the help that way.
All right. That's the Moveable Feast here.
But you can call us.
Can't call direct.
You can call direct and we'll take you that way.
All right. Thanks for coming in. We appreciate it.